Let us see carving and polishing. So many of the times what we have seen is you guys do good teeth arrangement, but while carving and polishing, the relations whatever you have got will go for toss, because you soften the wax so much that the position of the tooth changes. So I have certain tricks here where you can still maintain the tooth position whichever you have established, and still do the carving and polishing. The first thing is to fill this buccal sulcus or the entire sulcus which has been gained by doing border molding. Don't keep half. This is the right technique to fill the wax in the buccal sulcus to have the peripheral seal. And second thing is all the buccal and lingual surfaces of the denture, that is polished surface which Dr. Ajay has spoken, has to be concave. Why it should be concave is the tongue has to rest in this concavity, and the buccally, the buccinate also has to rest in the concavity. This is the second principle while carving and polishing. Now, we have scalloped and rolled in margins of the gingiva. We have a cuspid eminence. Here you can see a thick cuspid eminence. We should do good festooning, that is scalloping, and the interdental papilla should be concave, meaning the interdental papilla should go inside. There should not be any bulk in the interdental papilla. So as when you see the arrangement of gingival margin from the canine to the second premolar, there is gradual lowering of the margin. So in the teeth arrangement also we have to try to establish this margin. When we do the palatal polishing, we have to be sure that the palate thickness of the wax or temporary denture base should be at least 2 millimeters or maybe 2 point little higher, so that you can reduce while polishing. So this is an attempt I made to show you demonstrate the carving, because there are very much limited resources. The colleges are closed, the clinics are closed. But I try to do one small demo of carving and polishing. Here, what I have taken is upper teeth arrangement. Use an iced water. You have a burner. We have a wax spatula. We have lacquer carver, a gauze piece, and little bit of wax. My favorite instrument is this PKT carver. It is called. It's like a lacquer carver, which is small, which has got good control when you are carving. So first you start removing the excess wax, that is after waxing up, you remove the wax and you expose the cervical line. There, all the teeth, as I showed you in the teeth set, have a cervical line. You have to expose till that cervical line, then only the aesthetics of the complete denture will be seen. So you scallop, I mean you remove the wax, look at the direction where I am holding and slightly bevel that margin, so that you don't have a big rollover of the wax which will look very very thick. So now what I'm doing is I'm removing the excess wax from the labial surface. Then what I'm going to do is carve out the free gingival margin. So what I prefer is to carve a free gingival margin probably a millimeter and a half below the gingiva. This is your marginal gingiva. So after I carve all of the marginal gingiva, then I start festooning or the root carving, which I think is a slightly long video. Now you take out the wax from the interdental area to make it slightly concave. I don't want any bulk in the interdental zone. Then what I do is after adjusting the interdental zone, I start carving the roots. See, all the curvatures of the roots are distally tapered. So in the same manner, I draw a line on the wax rim with the distal curvature. So keep on finishing, and then just see what I am going to do. I am going to finish and then dip it in ice cold water so that it hardens so fast, so that the position of the teeth are not changed. Okay, then what I do is the root carving. See, I'm stuck at the root carving where I make the roots slightly prominent, and in the canine I make it more prominent to give the canine eminence. This canine eminence is very very important to have the lip support in the corner of the mouth. if this canine eminence is not there, there will be depressed look in the canine, and which will increase, which will show as the patient is old patient, you know, aged patient. It's like that. So I carotid canine, if you see, the roots are distally curved, and then we go ahead, yeah, more and more finishing, go ahead with, keep on finishing, yeah, this is what I wanted to show you. So this is a gauze piece, like 4x4 gauze piece, dip it in water, and from the pre-gingival margin, you keep on polishing towards the sulcus. Until you get rolled gingival margin and a proper root curvatures. So the lacrim scour creates a lot of scratches on the wax, so this will make it smooth. So after you make it smooth, then you blow torch it. So you blow torch it and you just dip it in water to harden the wax. Better to use a hard base plate wax and then finish it. So this is how the carving is done. Don't make too prominent the root, which is commonest mistake I see in the secondary rites. So they make too much root carvings, you know. So they should be very, root curvatures should be very subtle and very smooth all over. I do not prefer any root carving in the posterior aspect beyond the canine. I prefer the pre-gingival margin carving, because the posterior aspect has to be as smooth as possible to accommodate for the buccinator muscle. So to conclude my presentation, the aim of the teeth arrangement is to restore the aesthetics and oral function with a minimal adverse effect on fragile residual alveolar ridge. The arrangement of the teeth should be as natural as possible, and a variety of occlusal scheme advocated by various individuals. But the balanced occlusal scheme appears to be the most popular concept.